I think that the first step, and we've talked about this on so many episodes, for any martial arts schools, you need to get your internet presence right. You need to get the basics in line. And it's, I'm always amazed when I see great businesses that have a really solid model or are even run by business people, and they haven't lined up all of their internet presence yet. Mm-hmm. And it's one of the first things that needs to happen. So first thing, boom, Google Business. If there's one thing that we know, it's going to be that someone who has not yet gotten into martial arts and doesn't necessarily know what they're looking for, but wants to go try it, is probably going to start with a Google search for whatever martial art they're interested in their town. So we've got to make sure that we have a legitimate presence on Google Maps. We could be talking all the way up to advertising, if that's something that someone has the budget for. But at the very least, you just need to have a filled out profile with your accurate information. And I think that there's a couple things you can do to really beef that up. The first thing we always do is content, right? So like any new client for us, I'm going, great, when are we doing a content session? Because what you need on your Google Business first and foremost are great photos of you. It yeah. needs to be a total representation of your business, because people need to see why you're different from the place down the street. And sometimes you will win their business by having more great content on your Google Business than the next gym. If I see pictures of a welcoming environment and I'm new to martial arts, that's what I'm looking for. The next thing for your internet presence is obviously going to be your social media. And what's interesting about the martial arts world is I think it's quite similar to all the advice we've ever given in the health world, which is stay on the platforms that make the most sense to you, first of all. And generally, I think those platforms are going to be Facebook and Instagram. They are currently the places I would put most of your attention. If you have a personality trait or like making a certain type of content that is different, then absolutely find yourself on other platforms. But to check off your bases, you need to be a Facebook page that, again, just like your Google Business, has lots of pictures, is professionally set up, you've got all the places filled out, you've got a phone tree, and then you've got an Instagram. And the Instagram needs to be something that's at least relatively active. Like, we need to have photos going out on a regular basis for people to be intrigued. The last thing is you need to have a website. And your website needs to look like it was built in this century. I think that every martial arts gym is going to do their website a little bit differently. When it comes to a martial arts school, we need to show an experience. And I think that can be done on a way scaled down version. So, like, even for example, the site we mocked up for Criterion to help them put together, mm-hmm. that site, it's just a landing page. It's not expensive at all. It's super cheap to do that. And I think too many people get sucked up in, I need a full website. You may need a full website, but you may not. You may just need to be really creative with how you use a landing page. But ultimately, you want it to be really clear when someone goes to your site what it is you want them to do. And I think that so many martial arts schools are checking the basics off. They've got a contact form. Okay, you know, maybe I feel like putting in my email address. More likely, they've got a phone number. Okay, maybe I want to call you and talk about when I could come try a trial class. But I think there's so much we can do with a website. I think for one thing, a video introduction is huge. Mm-hmm. A video that not only shows people what they're going to get into, but also talks about, like, hey, you're probably on this website because you're new here. You know, I don't think a lot of current students are going to their gym's website often. It's because someone's new. So what they want to see is, what is my experience going to be like starting? What do I need to expect? What do I need to bring? What's day one look like? What I love about this, though, is that all these concepts we've been doing for years apply in the same way, that everything is custom and everything should be customized for your business, for your needs, and for who you are. And that can include the size of your business, too, in a major way.